Hello everyone, I'm Jenny from BU4U Gaming, and today we are back in Animalica, and I'm right back here at Apatia, of course. Still, I'm still pondering if I should move everything to Sliceland or what I'm gonna do, but for the time being, I mostly want to focus on adventuring, so it's kind of fine to have it here, and then eventually I might move it somewhere else. But anyway, we have some stuff to do before we move on, and for one, I want to build a carrot farm, which is the next one on the list, kind of, if I just follow the list in the settlements menu of the crafting station, because we got a T1 settlement agreement, right? And for that, we're gonna need some nails and some timber, otherwise I have everything else I need. Let's just make some of these, and we're gonna make a good deal more than that, what we actually need for that, because then we have extra nails. So let's just make 1,000. I do have the iron ingots, and then while we're in here, for one, we have some, we got a bunch of shards, so for one, we can upgrade our crossbow further, so we can make it into a +3, and then we actually have, I think it's 2 of the azure shards, so we can continue, and let's just upgrade it further. There we go, it's a +4, and we can go to +5. Then I need one more azure shard. I actually have some blue shards, so we could continue further, but we need one more of these. So there we go, now I have a +5 crossbow, and then I actually have one more green shard, so I could choose to upgrade a sledgehammer or a steel axe. I think I'm gonna go with the sledgehammer. I do some cut down some trees every now and then, but I actually feel like this is more bugging me more, that it takes so many hits whenever you have to pick up a building or something. Not that I do an enormous amount of building, but still, I feel like I need this more than I need an axe. So we are just gonna start with the sledgehammer here and just upgrade that one level, just like that. And then we actually have all three of these. We have slice and kill, we have shaki, and we have bloodbath, but I don't have quite enough. You need a whetstone. No, you only need a whetstone. What is it that I'm missing? Oh, it's the golden shard. You need a golden shard for all of them. You need a whetstone and a golden shard for this one to upgrade it for the slice and kill. Then you need a golden shard, a red shard, and a titanium ingot for shaki. But then you need a golden shard again for the bloodbath, as well as a whetstone. So the only thing I'm actually missing is one more golden shard. So we're gonna have to find that somewhere. But this one, once upgraded, is not as good as this one. This one is 35 damage and 1.5 speed. This one is only 23 and 1.6. It's a single sword though, so it would technically make sense that it does less, but you can't really carry two single swords and use them together in this game. Like, that would be two different slots, right, on your bar. So this one is definitely better, and by upgrading it, it's gonna be slightly better than the one I'm actually carrying down here, which is 34 damage, but then it's 1.4 speed. So I don't know, I don't feel like the difference is that big, but since we have the resources to upgrade them, I thought we might as well get at least two of these done. So let's upgrade slice and kill, and then shaki. And I wanted to actually try this because I don't remember. It's an improvised weapon, but it is an axe, and I want to see if this one can actually be used to cut down trees. Likely it can, I can't really remember. So if it can, then it's a twin, then it does 22 damage. What is the fully upgraded fire axe? It's only 20 damage, which means that if this one works, then or works well, just as well for cutting down trees, then it's actually better than the fully upgraded steel axe. So I want to test that out. We do have this raider axe, which also sells improvised weapon, right? And it's damage 12, but this one would be so much better. So we're going to take that with us and test it out. And then we're going to switch this out with the slice and kill dual katana. And then, of course, we have our +5 crossbow. So now we have a +10 and a +5. This we're gonna leave behind, and of course now this has been upgraded a little bit as well. I don't really have any ammo. I have some bullets I could use for the sniper rifle, but that's about it. But I think I have lots of arrows though, and a few special arrows as well. So I think where I actually want to go next It's gonna be Pestilentia. It's one of the harder biomes in the game. It has like a red circle in the menu. And well, we're not gonna need any Trank that's there, at least unless they have changed something around. I'm pretty sure they haven't. We're just gonna need lots and lots of ammo, or we can try and use. I want to practice using my melee weapons because I don't really use these much, do I? So I think I'm just gonna stick with my don't buy any ammo, at least for now, and that's where we're gonna go next. But right now we have the carrots farm as well. To make. So let's go in here. It's getting a little bit dark. Look at that with the sundown. It's really pretty. It is actually really, really pretty. Let's go in here. And then we're gonna make ourselves some timber. And I think we're just gonna max this out. I have some logs on me. Gives us a good deal of timber. And then we're gonna make the carrot farm. Go down here. So yes, we did the corn farm last time, if I remember correctly. So this would be the next one. Oh, we actually need woodlogs for that. Well, let's go out here. I should have some more woodlogs. So there we go. Yes, we are good on that as well. So we're going to go back in here. And then we are going to make that carrots farm. Yes, so now we can get carrots. And I have plenty. It takes 100 carrot seeds. But I have had over 600 of them or something. And you can also grow the carrots, of course, in the little gardening beds and use your carrot seeds for that. So that's what I would use the remainder of them for. Probably mostly I would use the gardening beds for decorative purposes, because most of what you can plant in there, except for the mushrooms, I think, and maybe the purple seeds or something, you can actually get settlements now. We couldn't in the beginning. In the beginning, you could only plant when once settlements and gardening beds and all this was implemented. We couldn't actually plant we couldn't get a settlement for carrots and cucumbers and peppers, and I think the chili peppers. I think the chili peppers actually doesn't have a so that might be one to actually plant in the in the gardening beds, because there's no settlement for that. So that could be something to do in the gardening beds. Okay, so since we're going off to Pestilentia, which is a place where there's lots and lots of enemies, lots of spawners and stuff, and it doesn't have a task. There's no task to clean it, because it's way beyond cleansing. It's like completely infested. You can destroy all the spawners and remove all the enemies for sure, and then it's just an empty place. It is, since it doesn't have a task and there's no objective to actually clean it, it's the best place if you want to have a long-term farm. If you want to make sure that you always have this specific type of enemies, and I want to be able to go somewhere so I can get whatever they drop. Like, for instance, if I need Gorehound heads and decide I want to build a Gorehound army from, you know, the Gorehounds you can get from the animal trader, then you can leave a farm there, or leave a nest there, and then just, you know, go there and farm them. And that way you can cleanse all the other biomes without having to worry about that you won't have enough of that particular drop, whatever it is they drop, right? So that's what I want to do. And you can just leave the nest as it is and go back, and then, you know, you go there and you kill them and you loot them, and then you wait for them to respawn. But sometimes it can be nice to keep yourself a little bit safe, right? So what I want to try and do, which I've done before, is to actually, where's the enclosures? I wanted to try something different this time. I want to try and make one of these. This is a smaller one. We already have this one, so we're going to try and bring it along, but it's quite big. And I don't even know if this is going to work, so it's just a little test. I want to try and see if you can put one of these around a nest, right? I don't know if it's going to be blocked from placing. That might be the case, but we're going to try and bring this as well. It's a bit smaller, because I feel like this is very, very big. So we're going to try and bring this one, which is for chickens. Or any other small, it could be for rabbits or whatever you want to use it for. We're going to try and bring that. And then, of course, you could mess around with some of the others. But for now, I just want to see if we can actually do this. And then we're also going to... We'll see if we're going to place some of these. But I think I'm going to try and do what I have done once before, a long time ago in an old video. I built a little farm with these. I think these were the ones I used. It doesn't really matter, just any kind of, you know, fencing, if you want to build kind of your own enclosure around one of these places. So we are gonna bring, let's say, 30 of these. Can I make that many. No, I could get 10. Okay, we need a little bit more resources for that then. Ooh, I do have the logs on me, don't I? Let's see. Yes, so let's max that out. That gives us 300. And then simple timber fence, max. I can make another 13. That might actually be enough. It's still the timber that is the limiting factor here. I know it's kind of dark right now. We're going to sleep in a moment before we place our carrot farm. But let's just do this. It does take a good deal of resources, but it's okay. It's pretty basic resources. I have lots of iron, so I can easily make more iron ingots and then make more nails. And it's not really a big deal to go and get some logs somewhere. There's lots of dead trees, so we can easily do that. You know what? Let's just make all of them into timber. And then we're just gonna make a few more. I think I used around 20 or something of these last time, but just let's just make a few extra. There we go. Then I think I have like 25 or something. So that would be kind of an enclosure. And of course, I haven't put a gate here. You could put some kind of gate in, but that might be tricky if you're trying to run away, if you kind of mess up or something while you're trying to kill them. If you just decide to go into the enclosure, the thing is, you can go into this enclosure and loot what you have killed. You can stand outside, kill them, and then go in and loot them, and then they might spawn again. But they have changed the spawning time right now. It seems to be really, really slow, so you shouldn't really be in a risk. They used to spawn a little bit faster at times. But what I want to do, I think I want to do pretty much the same as I did last time. There's many different things you can do, but I kind of like the little setup I had last time. So we're going to bring one of these. Just for the fun of it, it's not really something we need a lot. I wonder if we have the other stuff that I want to use for this. Furniture. Yeah, that has been removed. We had some really cool, very rustic looking, like little things that I actually really liked for that setup. But I guess we're just gonna do something different then. We could do something with some containers maybe. I actually want to bring a few of these anyway, so let's just make a few more of them. They're just really handy for building, or if you want to build your way up somewhere, then these can be quite handy to kind of, you know. We also have the treehouse with us, of course. And then I am thinking, what do we need for this? Nails. Well, this should actually be fine. This should be fine. Yeah. Let's just do that for now. We'll see how it goes. Let's get ourselves... Wow, it's so dark now. Can't see a thing. So let's just sleep, and then we are gonna sort this out, and then we're gonna head off to Pestilentia. Okay, it should be fine. Let's sleep 6 hours. There, look at that. We get our pretty sunrise. I love it. Man, things always take so much longer, but I like to do a little bit of this on camera instead of having everything pre-done and just said, oh, I placed this down. Oh, I did this. There we go. So we are going to place this, I think, just over here somewhere. It is just a temporary little place so that I can actually loot it a bit at times. So there we go. Look at that. That's our little carrot farm. Oh, I like that. It has a little basket. It doesn't have a person. It doesn't have a farmer, though, but I think someone else actually reported that. I seem to recall in the Discord that at least there was one of the settlements that doesn't have a farmer, like the other ones do. You can see someone's working over here. The carrot farm doesn't. Well, hopefully it will still produce stuff for us, right? The timer has started at least. Okay, so now we have that. I'm just going to pop off some stuff in my storages. We have some resources, and then we're gonna head off to Pestilentia. Okay, so we are ready to head off. So let's see if we can find Pestilentia in this list. It's probably one of the last ones. Yes, it is right here. And as you can see, it's a highly dangerous environment, and it looks very, very different from the from the other biomes. Once a lush jungle, Pestilentia is now a desolate land completely overpowered by disease corruption, which is why there's no task to cleanse this. You can do it, and there's definitely some cool stuff to find here. But yeah, there's no task that you have to like clear out everything in this biome if you don't want to. So let's get going. Ooh. Okay, there's definitely some things here that are different since the last time I was here. Wow, look at that blue circle up there. I already have some guys coming. I think we're just gonna use the normal arrows for this. Because they are just zombies. Or maybe we'll try and... Oh. They're probably... Oh man, you still managed to actually hit me. How close do I have to go like that? Okay. Aha! Okay, so we start out with zombies. That's fairly easy, but look at this. It's very, very dark. That's a new structure I haven't seen before. I think this little graveyard thing was there the last time I was here. Whatever that is over there, I haven't really seen before, and there's something on the ground there. Ooh, this is gonna be interesting. And yeah, it might not be somewhere where you would want to go this early on if you are about at the same stage as I am. That's definitely a personal... See, I really need some practice, but that's where the zombies are good for this, to actually practice on these guys. I don't think they have a spawner, but let's go and see. Is this something I can, like, destroy? I don't think so. But they're good at for practicing the melee and figuring out the distance. But I thought it would be nice to kind of switch things up, so I thought let's just go here and check it out, right? Okay, we have a couple more. Doesn't look like there's any spawner unless we can remove some of these trees. Okay. There we go. Okay, I'm stuck on something. Oh, see, now I went too close again. Oh boy, that is not good. Did I have someone else? No. Oh, it's a scorpion over there in the back. Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay, well, let's try and loot you guys. I don't think you have a spawner of any kind. They don't usually have the zombies, but... Or whatever they are. They kind of look a little burned, don't they? I don't think this is something we can... what am I trying to do? I'm trying to do this. Just wanted to see. Yeah, because usually it will pop up and say that you can destroy it with the flamethrower, right? Wow, look at that. This... It looks so creepy. This place is so creepy. Is there anything else here? I have to be careful I don't attract the attention of that scorpion out there. Oh, I did. Of course I did. Oh boy. Oh, there we go. Did I get the... Oh, it's just the sound that's weird. I was like, did I get the attention of something else? Because the sound... I could hear, it sounded like the sound was coming from behind me, which is really weird. But there is a little bit of a bug with that. Man, look at this. What is this? Oh, so creepy. Is that something I can destroy in some way? I don't know. Maybe we can destroy it with a flamethrower. But it doesn't seem like there's any new zombies spawning in. Ah, oh, there's definitely some changes here. This is cool. But yeah, there is a bug with the audio at the moment, but it should be fixed in the next patch because one of the developers has been working on it. There we go. Let's go in here, and then we are gonna take our stun gun. And yeah, can I do anything with this? Doesn't seem like it. Nope. It's just a creepy piece of decor. But yeah, I have a poison arrows on the first crossbow. Yes, I have to remember that. That's why it was taking damage. So there we go. We got beginning of this. We have lots of stuff over there. Oh, there's so much new stuff. This is so cool. I love when there's new stuff. That's fun. That is fun. But it's so dark here, it's easy to overlook if there's any kind of goodies. But it doesn't seem like there's anything here. So let's go and loot these guys before I forget. Mm-hmm. Because in the past it's looked differently. It's been changed a few times. But it's always been this kind of dark biome where it's always nighttime. But the general like layout and where the nests are, spawners are and stuff has been changed several times. So there used to actually be, I think, a gorehound nest here at some point, and there's also been a spawner with some of the other humanoid mutants. Okay, let's see what this one is gonna give us. Silver ore. Oho. Okay, well, let's go and deal with you guys. Oh, we have another one over there. Okay, let's just try and see if we can deal with these before we deal with the other scorpion. There's definitely more scorpions that's been added. But of course, they are also something that weren't in the game originally, so they have kind of been added gradually in different biomes. There we go. Okay, these guys are easy enough to deal with. Oh, I don't know what happened there. Let's grab this, and okay, you're still all the way over there. Okay, so we're getting some upgrading kits here for a sniper. And there we go. Which, of course, I didn't even bring. I could just have brought it, but it just feels a little bit overpowered sometimes. Okay, I have no idea what this is, but some kind of weird... I don't know. Containment unit, or looks like a piece of a satellite that dropped down, or I don't know. It is kind of weird. Okay, well, let's just do this again because it preserves some ammo. Oh, it's so weird with the sound because it sounds like it comes from behind me, that it's growling. That is so creepy with this audio bug. I feel like I'm running right into it right now with the sound. Oh boy. Okay, you're trying to hit me. There we go. But it's cool that they have different colors. They actually look really, really cool, these guys. I think they're one of the coolest mobs in the game when it comes to looks. Look at you. Just look at that face. Wow. That looks so cool. It is. I really like this. That's not the same way as I like a cute animal, but it is really cool. Oh, why am I pressing that button? Because I've been playing another game here, so now I can't remember which key it is I wanted. There we go. Look at that. I wanted a screenshot of it because it just looks so cool with the background and everything here. Wow, look at that. Very cool. There. Okay, let's just grab you. What do you actually give me? Monster scales and corrupted hats. But okay, it doesn't look like there's any spawners right here next to the balloon, so might not get around to trying to enclose one today, but we'll see when we'll find one. Let's just have a little look up here. Okay, there's some of these weird plants, but other than that, there's also something over here. It's just really, really dark here, guys. I'm sorry if you can't see much. It is really dark. Okay, it's a skeleton. Then we have like an old gravestone right here. Weird. Weird, weird, weird. Okay, well, let's keep going. I think that's kind of an indicator of, you know, enemies of being nearby or something. I'm not quite sure. I think it disappears once you clear the biome, but we'll see. There we go. It's also not a place that has a lot of, like, you know, resources in terms of course, not plants, because everything is pretty much dead here. So there is a little bit. You can see we found a little mushroom. There are some stuff we can mine. Are you just gonna give me silver again? Yes, silver and some stone and flint. So it seems like it's a good place for getting silver. Aha, there's a little dead plant over here. Oh. Oh, the music just... that creeped me out. Oh, okay. Well, let's go down here. And then we are gonna clear these. Oh, look at that. So weird. Okay. Do-do-do. See, now it sounded again like there's a kitty behind me, one of those mutated kitties, but I think it's actually over there somewhere. Okay, this is gonna get really confusing. I'm gonna be paranoid the entire time while I'm here. Oh, we got a survivor's sword. I don't think I found one of these yet. So, 1.5 speed and 10 damage. I still hope they're gonna add some kind of way that we can use these things as decor. Because we have a lot of like unique weapons, but not really any, like at this point, finding this in one of these like harder biomes, it's not the first place most people go. There's not really any use for this. I can sell it for 20 gold, but it would be kind of cool if there was some other use for them. And they have talked about adding some kind of display or something for them in further back. Oh, that gave me iron ore in development, but I don't know if they're gonna do it or what, but it would be kind of cool, right? To be able to decorate our bases with all these unique weapons that we find. Okay, so we have a pentagram here. Okay, that reminds me a bit of that weird head we had back in Amber Hills. I like this one more though. It doesn't look quite as plastic-like. The other one looked way too much like like some kind of plastic toy. This looks a little weird too, but at least it seems a little bit more fitting here. Interesting. Okay, well, lots of interesting things to discover. So what are you gonna give me? I know. And then there's another one of those things. Okay, well, let's move along. Okay, I feel like I am seeing, yes, there's a spawner over there. That's probably the kitties that I could hear before. So we can find some scrap metal here. There we go, metal scraps. The good thing is I'm getting metal shards, also some bones, because that's actually... Oh, I thought they had spotted me. Oh, they're ninjas. Then where are the kitties? I don't know. That's also... Okay, that has definitely... There's some stuff that's changed. Oh, this is so cool. But yeah, the limiting factor right now for me actually to make arrows is I didn't have any more metal shards. I do have some feathers and I have plenty of sticks. So let's just keep making some of these because we're gonna need a lot of ammo unless I keep using my melee weapons. Oh, there's also one of those over there, Jehenian killer hound or something it looks like. Okay, so we're gonna try our best to preserve some ammo here. Okay. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna leave you there because you do have a spawner over here. We're gonna try and get this person. If they can even be considered a person anymore, that's the thing, right? I do hear a kitty. Where is it? There's you. That's not you saying, making that sound. I'm really creeped out, so I don't really want to be... Oh, over there. Oh man, it's so dark. It's easy to overlook things here. But let's try and clear this. Oh yeah, there we go. What are we up to? Alright, we don't really have any... Oh no, I'm kind of forgetting about this now that I've gotten into the habit. I wasn't supposed to actually destroy that. That's right. That's right. I forgot. Okay, well, it's not a big deal. It's not a big deal. What do you get from these guys? Steel claw, metal shard. Well, they do give us metal shards, so in that sense, it would be nice. Is that all? And they give a cloth. A cloth. Okay, the metal shard deal. Of course, you can get the steel claws that you can sell. That's the only purpose of that. So that could be a good reason for keeping it, but I think we'll be okay. I think we will be okay. So... There we go, but I have to remind myself that I am not supposed to actually destroy the spawners right off the bat, because of course it would be nice if you want to keep spawners that you keep the ones that are the closest to the balloon, though we could also place down a ritual fire somewhere in this biome. If there's a place where there's a lot of spawners nearby each other, then we could put a ritual fire there instead of spawning in there, because there's not really many, there isn't really many... spawners right around this place, right? So there might be another place where we have some very localized, and that might be a better place to spawn in if you want to actually farm some mobs, right? There was that little kitty. There's a lot of like roaming creatures here now. That's a little unusual. You're right there. It's just very, very dark and really hard to see. Okay, so we got you. I don't think you have a spawner either, but here we go. Get my arrows back. And let's remember to actually do a little quick save. And we have that guy. I also see something wandering around over there. Okay. Oh, I actually shot him right through the head. Oh, wow. Look at that. Didn't I only shoot him 3 times? I thought I only shot him 3 times, but apparently I shot him 4 times. Oh, it wasn't through the head. It just looked like it when he was running. Okay, well, so far so good. Let's see, what is that up there? Looks like a dragonet. Can I hit you from here? No, it's a bit too far away. Okay, let's see what this is going to give us. Silver ore. Nice. Okay, let's preserve the poison arrows for some of the bigger stuff. Can I? Of course, you had to wander down there. There we go. We got your attention. I hear another kitty somewhere. Okay, these are pretty cool enemies too. Wow, yeah, look at you. But of course, these we can actually get some of ourselves in a tamed version. Okay, so far so good. So where's the other kitty that I could hear? There's like a dead tree over there. That's Dragonet. We see an enemy. There's something there. That building up there seems to have been changed too. There's a wall going all the way around. Oh. Interesting. Oh, did I completely overlook you? Okay, more iron ore. Let's just make sure to do a little check up here. We have this place. Doesn't seem to have anything of interest for us. Not really. Okay, I'm gonna leave that, but I might go and climb around later and try and see if there's actually anything of interest up there. Okay, now it sounds again like it's coming from behind. Oh, this is kind of... might not have been the best time to go here. I should probably have gone once they had fixed that bug. But I think we'll be okay. Just have to be a little careful because I can't trust my senses right now. Okay, so we have a dragonet over there. We have one little guy over there. The kitties are the easiest to overlook because they're so dark. Okay, we have lots of these guys. That is the mutant factory. At least it used to be, so I think it still is. So we're gonna have to go and check that out. Oh, there's kitties. At least one kitty. Uh-huh. But I think that'll be next time we're gonna go and explore that. Maybe they've made the biome smaller, or maybe we can go around the wall. Because there didn't used to be a big wall like that before. So maybe they've made it smaller. Okay, let's try and deal with you. Okay, you're such a big one. Let's do this, and... trying to figure out how to get up here to me, right? Okay, are you gonna make it up? Can you make it up? Oh, we have horses over there as well. The Jehanian steeds. There we go. Okay, you're down. Let's just see if there's anything of interest over here. Okay, we have another rock. Aha, more iron ore. Well, I'm kind of thinking since we don't have many other resources in this biome, that's why I'm doing a little bit more mining than I usually do, to kind of get something out of visiting this place. Ooh, nice. Quartz and stuff. That is nice. Okay, got that. 7 quartz and 9 silicon. Lovely. Yeah, let's just have a little look over here. Kind of looks like there's a rock way up there that one could mine. I think it's a gold rock, but another rock up there. But let's just leave it for now. I'm not too desperate for that at the moment, though we do need a lot of gold. But I'm gonna do some resource runs. I haven't had much time for it, but usually I do run through the biomes that we have already cleared and do some resource runs. At least that's what I've done when I've done previous series of this. I think I've only had time to do one so far. A little bit in land base, and I need to go back and sweep the biomes to see if I can find any animals that we missed. Okay, it doesn't look like there's anything here. Don't think we can mine this or anything. Just check. Oh, we can actually. Interesting. Ooh, okay, so iron ore. And of course a bunch of stones. Okay, well, I'm mostly curious if they've hidden something underneath the, this. That would be kind of cool. Oh, there's actually a jewelry box here. Oh, I love this. This is... I love this. Oh, we got a perfect diamond. So that's where you find it. I didn't know where we could find this. I knew it was added in the game, and I think there's only one. I'm not sure. They may have added more. But I know that it's specifically placed, and I didn't actually know that this was where we could find it. Oh, that's so cool. Oh, boy. Body. Oh boy, we have a body here. Oh, nice. Okay, well, now I know where to find that. That is awesome. Oh, yeah. Very cool. What is that over there? Uh-huh. Okay, we have a blue mushroom. Any enemies here? No, okay. We're just gonna do what we did in there. And both, well, I guess both Amber Hills and Green Hills, and kind of stay down a bit here. Let's try and take this. I don't really get much. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, it depends on the size of its tree, but about 5 hits with this one. And we'll see if we find another one. We're gonna have to test this one out, right? But it should if it works. The thing is, sometimes even though something does more damage, like for instance, the melee weapons, they do a lot of damage and you can use them to mine certain things. You can break the barrels or you can mine the shards, for instance. But if you go and hit a normal tree with these, well, I haven't actually double checked, but at least it used to be they would actually do very little damage at a time. So you have to use an axe for it because an axe is much better, even though the axe technically, like this one, does less damage, but it does more damage to a tree, right? So the same thing here, that if it is only designated a weapon, it should do less damage to a tree than an axe that is actually designated to cutting down trees. But since it is an axe, I'm going to assume that we can use it. We're going to try it, and then it should technically do more damage than this one because it's 22 and this is 12, right? If it's intended that you can use it for cutting down trees. Okay, well, we have a body we need to deal with. Or pick up, even though we are a bit low on time here. Let's see if I can find the body over here. We do have those horses. We have lots of enemies around here that we have to deal with. Can I get over here and get this? Yes. Nice. Okay, well, we're gonna have to continue with this next time, but wow, we found a perfect diamond. That is so cool. I think you need it for something at a special vendor in Kolchberg, if I remember correctly. I can't really remember the details for it. That is also something that was added a while back, and I didn't actually get to finding it in my previous series. So yeah, that was kind of new to me. A unique precious stone required to purchase one of the strongest rifles ever made. Yes, it's definitely for the madman. Who's a vendor in or trader in Kolchberg, and we can actually sell it for 3,000 gold, but don't get tempted to do this. Do not get tempted to do this. It's unique, which of course indicates that there's only one of them, and if you want that rifle, you're gonna need some other stuff for it probably, then do not sell this. And well, the same goes for the other gems if you want any of the special things that you can buy for them. So anyway, we are going to continue with this next time, guys. We have things to do. We're going to go and check out that facility in the next video. Maybe there aren't as many spawners anymore here as there used to be. Because then I have to stop telling people that they can actually use this place to set up farms. Because that might have changed if we can't get beyond that wall there. But I've seen other people say the same thing, that this is the, or still say the same thing, that this is a good place. Okay, well, we will, oh boy. How on, oh, I guess he wandered close enough. I thought he was much further away, but I guess not. Okay. I guess you just thought, since I was busy rambling, you could just climb up here and surprise me. Sneaky. Sneaky, sneaky, sneaky. Okay, well, thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming!